Welcome back. As per the instruction, I hope you have prepared the system. Sir, I'm using my Windows machine. And if you have installed the Visual Studio, from the Windows machine, you can make a search for the installed version of Visual Studio. So you can see I'm getting here Visual Studio 2017. So just open it. So when you will open the Visual Studio, you will get this start page script. Now here, let's see how we can create our project for doing the hands-on for the C# language. So just go to the file option and you will find here new project. So just click on the new project. Then under the Visual C#, we have for creating the console application using the .NET framework, for creating the console application using the .NET core. So one of the framework you have to use for creating the console application, because in the C# version history, I have shown to you, like C# latest version, we can run on the top of .NET framework, we can run on the top of .NET core. So here I'm just going to use the .NET framework. Now here just specify your application name. So what we are going to do in this sample, I'm just going to do here like how to create a program for adding two numbers. So here just define your console application name. So let's say I'm defining my application name like add two numbers. Then specify the location where you want to store this project. So I'm using here desktop, and on the desktop I have created a C# folder where I will put all my program. Then now select the C# folder, select folder. Then click on OK button to create a console application using the .NET framework. And guys, if you create the same console application using the Mac, so on the Mac you will find their .NET core, because .NET core you can run on the Mac and Linux, but .NET framework we cannot run. So I'm using the Windows machine, so that's why I'm using the .NET framework. But you can also use .NET core as well on Windows machine. But if you are using the Visual Studio 2012, 2010, 2013, so there you will not get the option for creating the console application using the .NET core, because .NET core is available from Visual Studio 2015. So here I'm just creating the project by considering, like it might be the case you have Visual Studio 2010, 12, or like 13 on your machine. So the same steps you have to follow here, don't worry. So first of all, here we are going to add two numbers. So for adding two numbers, we have to declare two variable. So let's see, declare two variable. So I'm just creating two variable of integer type, like say num1, num2. Now these two numbers we have to receive from the end user. So to the end user, we have to show the message so that he can enter the value. So in C# we have a class console, and in console class we have method writeLine. So using the writeLine, I can show my message to the end user. So I'm defining here, let's say please enter first number. This way I'm passing the message. Now we have to receive the number from the end user. So just that number we will store in this num1 variable. So I'm using here num1 equal to, again in console class we have a method readLine to read the input from the end user. But if you will see this readLine method, return type is string. So it will return us a string value. But num1 data type is integer. So what we have to do? We have to do here typecasting. So just convert this string into the integer. Convert dot to int 32 I'm using here. This way. So in this way we will receive the num1. Same way you have to receive the num2 as well. So just copy these two lines and write, just change the message here, like please enter second number. The second number you have to assign to num2. Now these two numbers we have to add by using a third variable, let's say integer result equal to num1 plus num2. So in result variable we will have the sum of two numbers, and this sum we have to shown to the end user using the console.writeLine method. Again, console.writeLine method. So you can show here like sum is, and in the C# we have a syntax to include your variable value within your string using the, you know, curly braces, then specify the parameter sequence like 0 1 2 3, like this way. So I'm using here only one variable, so I'm just using here 0, but if you will use more than one, so separated by comma, you can put here curly braces 0 comma curly braces 1, like comma curly braces 2, you can specify the value. So we will get the result here. So console screen will shown to us, but after displaying the message like sum is, the console screen will automatically closed. But if you don't want to close the console console screen automatically, so we have a method in console class like console.readKey. So until you will not enter a key, the console window will not be closed automatically. And even you can show a message as well, like console.writeLine, please press any key to close console window. So the console window will not be closed automatically. Now it will be closed when I will press any key. So let's see how it is going to run. Just click on this green icon. So this is the icon to run our program in C#. And you can see here, I am getting the option here like please enter first name. And here I have customized my console window font size. You can also customize on your machine. So we have the option, just do right click here and we have properties. So just go to the properties option, and from here you can find out we have the font. So from the font option you can select what the font size you want to show. So I'm using here the 24. So that's why it is showing the bigger font in my case. So it is asking for enter the first name, first number. So first number I'm entering here, let's say 4. Then it is asking for to enter the second number, I'm entering here, let's say 7. Then you can see I'm getting the message here like sum is 11. Now it is saying like please press any key to close console window. So when you will press any key, it will close the console window. You can see it's closed the things. So in this way, just like C++ language, we can write the program for adding two numbers. So in upcoming session, we will create such type of programs in C# as well. Thank you for watching this video.